Using the iron as a little mini hot plate like this is a lot of fun. Just set it to low, unclick the button at the back, slide the handle on top of the black bit, and then tape it. I've taped it down onto a tile, ceramic tile, so that it's safe. And then basically you just lay your card on top of that and wax on top. So I'm using the block of blue here direct to melt onto the card. Quite easy to do, very quick, very simple, and quite effective. Now, what this video is about isn't fancy, it's not high-flying, it's simple, fun, easy to do doodles, but they're great for cards and so on. And they're actually a lot of fun to do because you can be quite expressive, you can explore different things. Simple, easy, cleaning off with a piece of tissue, just wipe off that sole plate and onto your next card. So I've got some nice yellow all over the card here and I'm just going to scribble with this red, just scribbling, nothing fancy, and then some slower marks with the blue. Now you'll notice that crossways the card fits all the way, but longways some of it's hanging over the edge, so you have to sort of remind yourself about that and give the wax time. But it's a nice effective result. Again, cleaning off, I'm not going to show this every time, but onto the next card, this time some green. And what I'm doing here is dabbing just as you would for foliage with the normal iron if you were making a landscape, but I'm doing it upside down and covering the whole card like that. And then you can start embellishing. Now, I mean, I made this video simply by beginning and working as I went along, so nothing was really very planned. And these marks, these results are just doodles, literally, that I'm making up as I go along, exactly like you're going to. Tapping with the edge of the block. It's just to explore what effects can I get? Blowing it to make sure it's cool, and then there you go. Which way up should it be? Okay, last mention of cleaning the iron, so just do that every time. And now I've put brown all over the card, and as I put the blue-green on, you can see that the blue-green is actually showing quite clear and clean. It's sort of squeegeeing off some of the brown, and then scribbling on or putting lines of blue on, and then using a tissue. Now the tissue is made into a rough point, and it's quite dry when you start dabbing, so take your time at the beginning, and then as it gets a bit more waxed, picking up wax off the card, you can start doing different marks and working a bit faster. And what you're doing is creating an alphabet of marks, and then applying some wiggly lines or some straight lines, and it's a pretty and fun little card. Red violet, blue on top, that's the card base, and now rubber stamp. At the beginning the stamp is cold, so it's not very fluid in the way that it slides in the wax, but the more you use it, the warmer it gets and the white marks get bigger. It can create lovely results. Still with the stamp, this time I'm just dabbing onto the card, and you can see some of that colour from the last exercise, the last little doodle is still there. And I'm covering the whole of the card then, rubbing down with the edge of the stamp, pushing with the edge of the stamp. These are again alphabets of marks that you can make, and finding some direct colour. Notice, because the card's longer than the iron, that I'm having to slide the card, and that's one little fiddle. And then some darker colour down one edge, just building it up all the time. And finally a few more marks with the stamp to finish it off. Making a landscape sky, I always start with white and then put some pink on in this particular instance and some blue over the top. And if you notice, that right hand edge isn't really getting good colour, so I have to pull the pink back over it like this. It's all a bit liney, but well, that's what I've got for my sky. Now I'm going to damage this, I noticed, as I was putting on the horizon with the green. The sky got laid against the edge of the iron and made this strange mark, so I have to go and try and fix that whilst it's still warm. So again, going over it very, very lightly, and then lifting up carefully at the back now to make sure that that doesn't happen again. A bit of brown and a bit of red violet, and then dab. And you can see that when it's wet, it's quite big marks, and I've dried it off a bit and they're smaller marks. So let's have another look at this. White wax for the sky. Here I'm using yellow and some blue, again very lightly putting it on. White over the top to sort of pastelize it. And then here I'm using brown and some green, the basic landscape colours that pretty much always get used. Again, dabbing. When it's a bit wet and a bit hot, you get this type of dribbling effect sometimes. A bit of blue in there, and it's a different result, but still the same approach. I've speeded through the background of this to get the colours on the card so I can get to the sponge. I'm heating it on the base of the iron and then just dabbing it, rather like I did with the tissue. The sponge has already got darker colour on it from earlier use, and so that's going to affect and impact the image. But it's just another way of getting textures, very good for foliage sometimes. And then again, pushing with another part of the stamp's edge to see what different effects there are. And this is the beauty of creative doodling. Just see what you get, what you like, and then you can employ that in bigger pieces later on. Another tool is a wax shaper. So this has got a silicon rubber end to it, and that allows you to move the wax around without the wax sticking to it too much. So you can do all sorts of different strokes with it. Generally, it's sort of pulling back through to the clear white card underneath. If you use this on watercolour paper, for instance, then you could create some layering type of effects. But I found it quite interesting. It's not a tool that I use a great deal, but I am sure that I could use it more if I played with it for a while. Anyway, here I just sort of scribbled and dabbed and saw what it could do, and I quite liked the result. It was quite interesting and chaotic. Maybe time for a bit of music, eh? Not sure about the music, but anyway, this is a little sponge, quite a hard one, out of the white sort of rubber, and dab it, shuffle it, whatever you can think of to do with it. And here you can see I'm sort of blotting out a lot of the lighter colour, and just leaving that orange to flare, and then mounting it into something else. I noticed that I work in a sort of developmental way, so when I've tried out a new tool like that little sponge, I tend to do something with it very basically and then develop it. So here I find myself making an eye, and I'm dabbing it using the blue from the middle of that eye and sort of spreading that around. So the sponge is actually adding the colour, and when it runs out of colour, no colour. And now using that encaustic scrapey tool and just dabbing that to put on the detailing. Alright, and I notice that I'm starting this off in exactly the same way as I did the last one. A spirally squiggle in the middle and then radiating out. Sometimes it's nice just to do something quick, something that's effective. And good. Cleaning the iron, I said I wasn't going to mention that again, but I did. And I did because I'm doing this band of colour. And I'm going to make a sky now by laying the card very carefully on top of the wax and then sliding it off to my right side and lifting as I slide. You get these wonderful skies then. Really good way. And the landscape can be done that way too. Put some dark colour on, slide across. Bingo. Landscape. Dab it. Just to get your foliage. And this is a very fast way of making simple basic landscapes, which you can then embellish with the stylus or the edge of the iron. That's quite quick, isn't it? This film of blue wax is to create a palette so that I can put colour onto the rubber stamp. You see the stamp is picking the colour up, and of course it's cool now on the stamp, but because the card is placed over the saw plate of the iron, then that wax will remelt and print off. And I'm using the edge of that stamp just to create grass effect, and it makes an effective little image. Same card, so I don't want to waste it, obviously. And I'm just putting some green on, and when you put more wax on, it sort of liberates the original colour. Now, I had the idea to make a landscape just by wiping off, but it actually wasn't quite as easy as I'd hoped. And I wanted to use the stamp to create rocks and texture and stuff like this. So I'm using different bits of that one single stamp still. And then a sort of a bushy effect by putting the stamp over itself several times. It was looking a bit drab, so I added a bit of pink. And it wasn't my favourite image, but I mean, it's okay. I'm obviously into pink now, having just used it on the last one. So I'm just colouring the card using a similar palette to the one I did earlier when I did the sponges actually. And I'm going to start off by picking up a little white sponge, just the sort that you'd use in your home. And then, actually my favourite is this tissue technique. And once you've worked the tissue through the wax a little bit, it sort of picks up moisture and it's a very fluid little tool to use. It creates lovely effects. And then just finish off with a bit of wax around there to highlight it. There we are. Another favourite tool for the hot plate is torn card. Just take a piece of card, tear it on a fairly straight edge and let it be a bit rough. And then over the wax card, you just sort of wriggle it and drag it. So you're sort of squeegeeing with this torn edge through the wax. And you get these wonderful detailed effects. I'm speeding it up a bit here just to get through it. Lovely, eh? Decide which way up you like it. And off you go. Now I'm going to do a slightly bigger piece here. This is an A5 card, so I'm having to move the card around quite a lot, but it shows you that you can do that. Start off with the torn card, and then work with some of the other things. So I'm just whacking it all together now. Here's the stamp. See what comes out of that. Remember that it needs time to warm up to push the wax around effectively. Sponge. Again, warming that up a little bit can help. And all the time you're just watching what you do. Here's my favourite tissue. So now I can put lines and sort of a bit more detail, a bit more division probably, into the image. And here I'm doing a sort of echo effect. And that's it, I think I've finished there. Decide which way up I like it. I actually like this one, it's got a lot of sort of three-dimensional effect, but my favourite way up was the original way, that way up. So there you go, this is the iron as a little hot plate. Clean it off at the end, remember to tape it onto a tile or something. Above all, have fun. I'm Michael Bossom, thanks for sharing your time with me, I appreciate that. All the best and keep melting.